our 20-week scan, we found out he had fluid in his lungs, which was kind of the first red flag for us. And we just kept continuing throughout the pregnancy, keeping an eye on that fluid. And then ultimately when he was born, we did testing to find out that he had his genetic syndrome. This is Cole. So Cole has a deletion of one of his chromosomes. It's called 2Q23 microdeletion syndrome. He was in the NICU for about 3.5 months, had some medical challenges, one of them being low muscle tone, which is what requires him to need a wheelchair. His genetic syndrome is completely rare. I mean, there might be several hundred kids in the world with that specific deletion. We were just going day by day to figure out who Cole was. He's his own person. and we celebrate every little milestone, or what we call inchstone, along his journey. He loves sensory-seeking things, so he likes to play with toys, he likes to hear loud noises.
He loves being outside, he loves the wind in his face, he'll stick his tongue out and enjoy the wind, he loves the sun, he's an overall just joy to be around.
So it all sort of started with him touching the wheels. We didn't even realize it. We took him to the Houston Livestock Show Rodeo Cook-Off, and we're wheeling him around, having a good old time, and then we look down about halfway through, and he just has black smudges all over his face and his hands, and we had realized that he was just gliding his little hands along the wheels because he's so sensory-seeking. He was just having fun, touching the wheels, and we weren't even realizing it at the time, and then sure enough, he's putting his hands in his mouth.
For that reason, he wasn't able to enjoy the wheelchair. We pretty much put it in the closet and it wasn't being utilized because we couldn't take him anywhere and have him safely use it.
It was not sanitary, obviously, so we needed to find a solution.
Initially, we tried to make something on our own with cardboard cutouts. I think it was shoe boxes we draped over the sides, kind of like this, but it was real just poorly done and wasn't durable. So I made a Facebook post just asking some, you know, generic question, hey, here's what we got, does anybody have any ideas? And we had a bunch of people reach out with ideas and suggestions. But then Lauren, who I went to Stephen F. Austin with, she reached out and put me in contact with Mr. Richards.
And she said, hey, Mr. Richards, she said, look at this. We've got this friend of mine, and they got their son Cole, and they were looking for help with this. Is that something you guys would like to do? And I was like, oh, yeah, it would be great. So they came up with a bunch of ideas for that wheelchair.
We're not in the school district. I'd never met Mr. Richards before, but his willingness to
help us. So we start off teaching this stuff. You know, how do you take this and write it down? How do you make notes out of this?
It was amazing. He took it to the next step and really took the initiative to involve his class.
I've never been one to not accept a challenge. it's fun. I've probably spent most of my 6 years teaching intro to engineering class looking for projects like that. And it's actually hard to find things that are real life applicable where they design, they make, they create, and then we can apply it to something in real life. This is something that kids can put their hands on. They can give it to Cole's parents and walk away and know that they accomplished something, even as freshmen in high school.
We're proud that we get to like have the chance to help him in a way and help him and him and his family from having problems from touching a wheel and getting his hands dirty.
Having the students creating something, one of the parameters for the project was they knew that they had to create something that was easy to attach, easy to take off so that Cole's parents could adjust that later on. You know, we didn't want to create something that was permanent, had to be welded, you know, cutting any part of the wheelchair. All of the designs the students had would either clip on, could be attached with some screws, because there's a under the armrest, there's two screws that hold part of the plastic covering in place. And so we took those screws out, replaced them with longer ones. So the one prototype was connected with those two screws and some washers.
These are 3D printers that allow us to like make our things come to life, make them more realistic.
All of them were one print. They didn't require multiple pieces, so that was easier for the students to understand the geometry and creating the design and the product. That helped a lot. It was kind of amazing to me to think that they didn't have something for that already. So I think that was part of the challenge, that companies don't create products for that because most people want access to the wheels. So it was different. It was a neat challenge, and it was fun to see students understanding this is why it's different. This is why it's not something on the shelf. We worked almost nonstop for about 2 weeks, from the design sketches in the notebooks to 3D printing out the first versions of their product. So the wheelchair he has is really cool because it'll be adjustable. They can make it wider, they can make it taller without having to go buy another one. So that was another thing I wanted the kids to keep in mind too, is this is a chair that he'll use for a while, you know, until he doesn't need to.
Wow, look at there, Cole.
Look at that.
Oh, that's perfect.
Like, I got all kinds of things. Yeah. Like that. So here we go.
Can we try it out?
Oh, yeah, we can.
Look at that.
What do you think, Cole? Best. Look at that. You get, you can put some fake remote controls on there and you can drive that sucker.
Woo! Yeah, look at there, bud.
I think it was really neat for our students to be able to meet Cole and see his family today and be able to say, hey, look, you know, he put his arms on the little armrest and just sat there and it was just like he was made for it, or it was made for him. And I think that really meant a lot to the students. And we're trying to kind of tell the kids too, like, he's not going to say, yeah, this is great. You know, he doesn't express himself that way, but I think, you know, immediately putting his arms on and just laying his both his hands on the armrest, even though they weren't the same, he doesn't care about that. You know, just seeing him put his hands there, and then later on he was clapping and smiling, you know, just he was really comfortable. He was, you could tell that he was very happy to be sitting in his wheelchair again. I mean, across the board, the students did an amazing job. They all enjoyed it so much. It was fun because they knew they were helping a little guy that has a very particular need. That we could address, and not everybody else could do that. So yeah, it was loads of fun. Definitely an A+ project.
I'm excited. I'm very excited. Cole's gonna be able to enjoy so much more outside. We're not gonna be paranoid and anxious, you know, constantly wiping his hands off from soot and dirt. So it's gonna relieve our minds a lot with being able to enjoy being outside with him.
The feeling that comes to mind for me is just very blessed, because honestly, I had kind of figured we were giving up, like there was not going to be a solution. We were just going to, like Zach said, put it in the closet and maybe bring it back out eventually when he knows how to self-propel.
Hi. You like your wheelchair?
So it's just really cool that we have these creative thinkers out there and technology to do that.
Reading makes me happy.
It makes me happy as well that I got to do a project that could help him.
I didn't even know that high schools had 3D printers in them. I mean, we were just both amazed. Like, wait, y'all can do this with a 3D printer? Like, I'm learning about the 3D printers myself, even just throughout this process. I had no idea you can just think something up and it comes to life. I mean, that's exactly what we needed in this situation. It's one less worry for us. It's one less thing that we have to worry about and stress about, like getting him out and being accessible. It's just gonna be a game changer for us.